Kanarun, who gets it? Yopaj!
That's a jump! Yopaj, he's able to get it, still the fellow Kanarun, and they turn and they blow up side! They turn over towards Matumba, man, they're bringing him down low. Matu, he's trying to run, but Skep, he's just chasing him down!
Skep got straight this, he's in!
Nisha's coming in with a BKB onto death, but the BKB soon to wear out for Nisha. Nisha's got to run! Yopaj, he kills off Yapzor. Zai's trying to turn with the siphon onto
Skep.
They get the spear connection back on. See if they can get into this and find the initiation. Over to the side, though, Death's been found. Nisha, he'll go for the spear, but Death pots the BKB straight away. He's going to start to head off. Zorn walk back. Yopaj jumps in. They get the coil.
Snap
they get
the
snap back onto Nisha. They've taken out Nisha. He's dead for 80. Twamel getting run down by Zai Matumba Man, but Yopaj is able to reset. Jumps out to the side. He's already looking to get
hook
back
shot
in.
Hookshot. Available.
Catch onto Skem. Skem, silence. Yopaj jumps in with the silence onto the two of them. Catches both the clock and the DP. Yopaj pushing back Puppy. Skem. Trying to run down Zai. Zai taking down the Spirit Vessel. Yopaj on the high ground. He's going to be able to jump out in time. He is. Blink back to safety. He's okay. As they're waited out, and he's now ready to get back in with the exorcism shortly coming to an end. I believe they're able to catch him before he's able to get the BKB off at all in that fight. Already we have Obi-Nion hunting into the jungle. A secret, secret. They've got to be careful. There's going to be the jumping from Yopaj onto Yapzor. Yapzor underneath the tower. Skem. Still looking to try and get a catch here, though. Drop the Dream Call down onto Yapzor. Zai getting the Shiva's Guard out, but Death straight in with the Jewel. Gets the catch onto the DP. Skem turns as well, and they got the damage to bring down Zai. They do. Zai goes down. Yapzor tries to get in, but there's too much damage that's being kicked out by Skem Sleshrak. Death getting low underneath the tower. Death, will he be able to escape this? He won't. He will tick down as the damage from the tower is too much for him to withstand. Jump forward from Nisha, trying to see if he can get the catch.
Good pushback.
By the psychic headband, play hard. Maybe see if he can even get back in on this, but the arena's dropped. They've got the catch on Skem, locked down to the arena wall. Secret will be able to take down Skem in return. Coming through fairly shortly, though, so Secret can stick around and keep pushing. 1:30 on the Aegis. See if they keep a bit of a better track at that timing compared to last time. It's already Death in on the back lines. He jumped in with
good
the
stun.
The full on stun, one of the two of them. They've got the stun on to Zai. Zai goes down. As they bring down the DP, Skem just heading straight towards the back lines. He's on top of Yapzor. Yapzor will fall. It'll be a buyback from Death as they'll look to continue to push back Secret. Batu turns over towards Dragon Well. We'll be able to pick up the triple.
Going ham.
Now he's over towards Skem. Skem on the retreat up to the high ground, gets away.
That's one buyback from Zai, one buyback from Death.
Yopaj has been silenced. They've got the spear, they've caught him, and it's another for Matumba Man. Game one.
This Lashrak feels super tanky and a lot of synergy with the Guardian Greaves and Oracle ulti. Puppy drops the ult.
They're going to try and go in on this. Zai actually not able to catch Death with the Rolling Thunder. They do lay down the Balance Strike. Death getting burst, though. They'll be able to take out the Lash on the front lines. Now they'll turn over towards the Oracle. Snowball coming in towards Zai into the Wukong's Commander. Playout steps out. Yapzor in with the Echo Slam onto the two of them. Gets the jump onto the Tusk, onto the Gyro, but this BKB's out. Skem can just stand his ground and he's ready to fight back. With the BKB, they've got to run. Matthew's going for the TP out. Will make it away, but it's three dead on Secret.
Almost four dead. Like, that was a clutch.
See what Secret can do. They weren't able to pull off anything in the top lane in terms of a defense. See if anything's going to be different this time round around the mid. As the tier 3 tower is falling, Yopaj, he's in! He's able to get the
grab! Gets the jump!
Straight away on Matumba Man, dragging it back into the rest of the team. Matumba Man, he's going to get taken down. Down for a minute, no buyback. As Matumba Man's gone, Zai as well. Nisha, he's got to blink out. It's two cores
dead on
Secret.
This might be it.
I think it might be.
They don't have a Sonic Wave. Everyone's pretty much full HP, full mana. Gyro, he wants to die. Like, he's like, I don't
yep.
care. Give a damn, you know? I still have 40 seconds left on that Aegis.
It's just nothing that Secret can do. As Obi-Nion having a phenomenal mid-game moment.
There it is. They just call it.
They're tapping out. It's too much for Secret as game two is going to go the way of Obi-Nion. Obi-Nion wanting to step up the aggressive posture and try and get something done with the Aegis on Yopaj. Yopaj. On the shackles onto Matumba Man. Charge coming in as well for Dwarwell. Continue to keep him locked down. Silence out on Yopaj. Matumba Man going to turn with the axe in the BKB. Nisha, he's getting focused though. Nisha's going to use himself.
Can they break?
Batu,
no.
Going to get the battle toss up just in time. But Yopaj, he can continue to kite him. Turns with the pass shot, gets back in with another shackle. Matumba Man's going to fall as the battle toss comes to an end. As him and Nisha are dead and gone. The rest of Secret, they've got nothing left to show in this team fight. They've got to back off.
This global presence, like they can be anywhere on the map.
That's the setup, Yopaj. Starting things with the shackle. Dramwell coming in. Puppy trying to blast them back, but with the lockdown and the ultimate coming in with the snowball as well. They're chain stunning him up. He's just going to get blown up.
Red of nature.
I mean, that nature's wrath seemed like it did about 1,000 damage.
Mostly nature's profit. You can also like jump Pugna. in the back lines, get a burst on him. Like, there's so many targets that they need to focus. Yaps are rolling.
So we can get this Yaps up. Silence on to Yo Patch. Death. He'll be fine. Gonna go for this kill here. They've got the set of Nisha. She's popping the BKB, but it's too much damage. As Nisha, he'll go down. No chance to pop the cheese. It looks like he didn't want to there, maybe deciding against it because he knew it wasn't a fight that he could turn around. Still, that's him down for a minute.
And he's TPing on Treants on the top. Like, if he gets a good shackle angle. Ooh, that was close.
Doesn't quite get the latch this time, but he's got backup as they're in onto Zai. TP as well from Skem. Matsu's going to try and turn over towards Skem, but the BKB's out. Same to be said from Matsuma Man as he continues to try and commit. The shackle's out to Zai. Shot down by the passion. The defensive Decrepify keeping Tramwell safe and allowing him to back away, but he still gets found by Yapsil with the kick. All over towards Skem. Skem focused by Matsuma Man, but Matsuma can get his drain flow by Death. That's the Aegis gone. Now they're ready to look for a second round. Silence
Spirit
being kept
Breaker
on
coming
by
in.
Yapsil. Jackal over onto Matsuma Man. See if they can finish this. He's getting taken out. Tries for a TP, but the snowball comes out for Play Hard into the shot from Yo Patch. And Yo Patch, he's not done yet.
Oh, the angle.
Yo Patch locks down Puppy. He's got the two, and then Puppy and Yapsil held in position. They bring down Puppy. Turn over towards Yapsil. Yapsil down as well. And team wipe.
That's a full five-man team wipe.
Oh, well. Ready to go. And onto Puppy. TP's coming in. Puppy's trying to get back, but they've got the dust. They pop the scepter, but there's the control. Tramwell gets winning with the ult. Takes him down. And behind the tower, they're trying to take down Skem, but the backup's there. Playout comes in with a punch up onto Matsuma Man. Yo Patch focusing him down with the focus fire. See if he can continue to kill this. The battle trance is out from Matsuma Man, but Yo Patch can just kite him. Brings himself away from Matsuma Man. Matsuma Man will manage to get his hands on Playout.
Gets the cheese off.
Two of them. Buyback from Puppy. Secret, can they chase for more?
They need to get more. This is going to be the fourth kill.
Cannot charge out in time. They bring him down. Zai, Puppy trying to chase over towards Yo Patch. Yo Patch turns, shackle out to Zai, but he's going to bail. He knows the rest of the team's secrets on the way over.
Troll getting recalled.
They can go for Death underneath the tower. Matsu's in with the jump, the pistol, but the save's there for the snowball. Buyback comes out for Playout. They're looking to turn this, looking to punish Matsuma Man for the time. Matsuma Man is able to get the BKB and the bounce. Trance off, turns over towards Death. Charging from Tramwell, kiting up Matsuma Man for now. Matsuma Man, he's held on the low ground. Yo Patch trying to keep his distance. The tower hits coming in. Yo Patch heads back up towards Matsuma, takes it down at once. The Aegis has gone over to the side. Nisha caught in the sprout. Skem stands his ground. Yule Scepter will dodge the shackle shot. Nisha's still good to go. Roll forward from Yapsil straight on the wall. Skem kicks him back. Skem will fall down.
He needs 50. Also
down. I mean, let's see if they can. Already Zai's popping the ult. He's ready to make moves over towards the side. Trying to chase down Death with another fight, but the low sword's out. Roshan falling like Matsu with a very early BKB usage there. Matsu won't have the BKB for this fight. That might not matter though, as Death gets blown up. Yo Patch tries to come in from the side with the shackle, but he gets turned upon. Matsu just turns over towards the wind range with the abyss of the MKB. Yo Patch goes down immediately. Triple buyback coming out from Obi Neon. They're trying to get back over to help Tramwell, but Tramwell focused by Secret. Tramwell will fall. A fourth buyback used. Snowball in. Play hard. He makes the jump over towards Yapsil. They bring down the Earth Spirit. Chase Yapsil continues to Yo Patch. He's looking for Matsuma Man. Stem. TP's in. The Sprout to block him off. Matsu, he's stuck. He's trapped, but he is on the high ground. They don't have vision up him quite now. It's Matsu. He'll turn. They force Skem in, but Skem's got the BKB. The Shackle connects on the Matsuma Man. Play hard. Matsuma Man gets taken down. Down for 100. The glide there holding
snowball.
Back Puppy inside. Play hard. Moves over towards the backline. Triple kill for Death. Over towards Puppy. The Yo Patch takes him down.
They're still chasing.
So they
catch scouted
well,
him
they
out.
Yo Patch scouts it out with a parachute. Shackle shot to follow up as Zai will fall.
Secret, they have a ward on the high ground. It's being pinged out.
Yo Patch, he's stepping in, but he's been silenced. Drama's gonna come charging through straight away. Jump from play hard over towards the back lines. They're looking to focus down to Superman, but Superman's able to put the BKB in the battle shot. First of all, the attention's gonna be drawn over towards the illusion. Now it's turning towards Yo Patch, but steps
second
in.
Eon.
The glide there holds the back. Yo Patch is able to step away. They're in onto Superman, but Superman gets taken down. Side Nisha will be able to run down Yo Patch. Yo Patch immediately in with the buyback. Nisha, they crop to the side. Eon just will be propped, but Skem standing his ground, and Yo Patch is ready for round two. Comes back in. See if he can chase this down. The BKB from Nisha is shortly going to wear off. Secret now on the retreat to see what sort of a move they can force out from Secret. Open the sprout outside of the pit to get the vision. We'll see the wolf bite onto Matsuma Man. Matsuma Man, he's ready to go, but onto the side. Tramwell goes straight in with the charge. Over towards Puppy. Nisha turns towards the two of them. This is going to be the invis for now. Keeping Tramwell safe as he gets away with the tricks of cloak. Over to the side. They're on top of Death. Death, he's been bashed up in control, but Death, he's able to get the cheese off. He gets a second chance at living here. Death, still alive. Finally. nearly falls to the side. Finn is dead stop, buys back over to the side. Play
Matu on Vendranger.
Onto Yabzor. See if they're able to push back Yopatch. Yopatch continuing to be chased out by Matumamat. Matumamat staying in the bash is there. Yopatch taken down. Drawwell is well in trouble. The secret to find a third. Buyback's coming out for the three of them, but Skem, he needs help and he needs it now.
Where's the bash?
BKB, the four of them focusing down. Skem, Skem trying to go for the TP out. Is he able to make it in time? He isn't. The stun comes in as the BKB comes to
They're looking to go in. They're going to use that Rexus go forward. Illusion Rune trying to maybe turn this around. They've got the Exorcism, but the damage with the finger, they'll take out Leo style. Omni Slash bouncing around, but it's not going to be enough damage to take out anybody outside of IG. Just yet, they'll look over now at MJZ, who will pop the borrowed time. And that's going to be the IO getting out as they'll look to continue forward and find themselves Muz. They've got two kills, looking for a third. Borrowed time already used on cooldown for another 45. So when the homing missile hits, the life will end. And that's MJZ falling. 3 heroes dead on the side of Thunder Predator.
Frank already smoked up again. Yules.
Yeah, might clash over mid.
Oh, I have to be so careful here.
Look over. There's no DP. And now they've got the Hex that's out onto the Mars. They'll use the finger, but there's the Terrorize. It's going to fear back the Lion into the Bramble Maze. Rolling Thunder coming in, but is it going to be enough? Goes into the Shadow Realm, and Moose is going to be able to get a kill onto Kaka.
Nice
they've
spear.
Got the Arena with the BKB being popped by Flyfly. They only got the Lion, and Ollie's already out of the fight as he died over bottom. JT trying to swashbuckle away, but the Yules is out from Leo style on the JT. Shield crash right on top of Frank, who will use that God's Rebuke. They've got the Shadow Realm strike as well as the Mist Coil coming in from MJZ to get the kill on the JT.
I get an impale
spike
on.
In.
He almost lost 1% of his health. Nope, back to full.
100 more Earth spikes, he may get him. Rolling Thunder coming through as well as the Blink Dagger. They've got the Hex as well as the Finger, but that's going to be reflected back with the Lotus Orb. They'll get the kill on Kaka, now they're going to look towards the rest. Blade Fury, Emo, top of the BKB. Focuses his attention over onto Frank, who's onto the high ground and left alone. They'll get the kill onto the Mars. That's okay from IG, but it did cost Kaka the buyback.
I'm sure they're happy with this still. They got the top Rex. They didn't even have to use Exorcism, which is now level 3. Ollie again.
Terrorize, and they catch Ollie. They've got the Omni on a Flyfly.
What damage!
The damage is there, and they will get this kill.
GG!
Take out Flyfly, and woo! GG is called.
There's just no chance. And they're smoking into them here, so potentially there's a team fight they can take. With the Dusa ult.
Control a little bit low. Hunkering dive. That's going to get some vision. They've got the silence out of
Dusa. Dusa out of mana already.
Control already out of mana. Mino's in trouble. The Walrus Punch comes in onto the puck. They'll look over as they kill off Emo, but they lose Leo style as well as MJZ. MNZ trying to get out with a false promise, but won't be able to do so.
Do Lemons even have Roots Core? I don't know what Lemons have. Mino's getting burned up here, taking a lot of damage.
He's caught. I don't think he gets out of this one. He will use that.
Or Phoenix dead, though.
Find Kaka. All right, that's a start here for the side of Thunder Predator. They're going to go after now. Flyfly, who might be in a little bit too deep. Rooted up. Right click's coming through on the Timber. He gets that Battle Trance off.
Roots.
Will start to throw at those right clicks. Those Roots. The false promise. It's there, but the Primal Roar comes out on the Minos. They've caught themselves. MJZ. They'll get the kill to the Oracle. The Dream Coil is going to walk up too. They'll finish off Minos. They'll go after the Timber. Frank the tank. He's a tank no longer. He's falling apart, and he will drop. He's too fast.
No stuns. Oh, he got coiled again.
Oh, Leo
double damage.
Style pops the BKB, but he's got the double damage, so you need to run.
He's dropping through BKB.
You're not going to be able to do so. They've got the false promise, but the Supernova, now their attention's going to go into the Medusa, who tries to hit the egg, and that's the wrong thing to do because you've been caught with the Roar, and they've got the Sunray on you with the help of Emo. The Waiting Rift, that's going to hit on the three of these heroes. It silences up. Everybody's going to try and help this Medusa. There's no Snowball available because he was silenced by that Waiting Rift, so they get the go on Aminos. They look towards the back. This is the beginning of the end here. Leo style dip for 35. They've got no Medusa for 45, and here they go. Diving in even further. They've got themselves the Waiting Rift with the double damage still going. They get the kill on MJZ. These heroes are being corralled into their base, and Thunder Predator have nothing to give. They'll call GG.
It depends on the scenario, but generally, if you're affected by that,
Lightning Vortex in. They've got the Geomega Crypt that's going to silence them for a second. They've got the Supernova on the
Great
high ground.
Positioning.
Get into this. Yes, they are. They've got themselves the boat coming through. Frank ends up dead. Supernova goes off. They'll stun up his Rain Team. He gets the first life out of his hand, so Minos needs to be careful. He'll try to run, but he's been rooted up, and he's killed off a second time.
Because otherwise, there's no hope here.
Ball Lightning in. They've got the silence on a Frank. They'll use the Supernova. And there's no way for them to blow this up. They've got the Hex onto the Void Spirit. They look over at Frank. He's one shot from dead. They'll get the kill. Emo getting crit for that one. Leo style falling to JT. Two heroes dead on the side of Thunder Predator. Down 13k, and they're working on their last tier 2.
Xbox
go. TP down here.
If he dies now, so bad for him.
Have themselves the boat, and they should be able to get that kill here onto Minos. It's his first flight. They've got the electric vortex. They'll get the Kona moves, and the supernova isn't going to line up. Well, they've got the shackle, so it doesn't matter. They've got the control on Minos. They'll get the Kona to the Wraithing, and they'll look for more. Running away is Frank, as well as the ancient apparition of NJZ. They'll catch them both with the torrent, and Fly with the double kill, taking out both of them. They've got the hex onto Leo style.
Long range.
Should be a full team wipe. Aether Remnant isn't going to be enough. No, it won't be.
Minos gets hit for a second. They've got the Serpent Wards down. They're going to commit for this tier 3 over bottom. Fly leading the charge. The 7k lead. Can Thunder Predator hold on to this one? They've got the Hex. Sunray on him. Bonus damage hits on a Fly.
So much damage.
Vortex. That's out onto this Wraith King. And while Minos running away, he ends up surviving just with a sliver of health as he stays in this thanks to the Glimmer Cape. But Ball Lightning over. They'll get the first life out of the hands of this Wraith King. Can they follow it up with more? Yes, they can with the Blue Dagger as well as the BKB being popped by the Shadow Chomp. The full
check out
the Wraith King. Minos, he's in a lot of trouble. Touring up into the air as well as the Vortex. They've got the boat coming in with the BKB. He's able to walk away. They don't have any kills just yet on the side of IG going after Thunder Predator, but he is real low. Right clicks out.
Evo doesn't have ages. Can't use cheese.
And he's in trouble. Eats the cheese, survives for longer. Fly moving in. They've got the right clicks as well as the silence out of the Wraith King, but nobody dead on the side of Thunder Predator just yet as Moves ends up dying to Ollie.
We didn't see the Aegis on maybe the storm over the troll who feels more unkillable. They're going to go in for this.
They're going
for more of the Ball Lightning Vortex. That's going to pull in Frank. They've got the Yules with BKB being popped by Emo, who focuses his attention onto the Pangolier. Now go all the way back while landing on Minos. Minos trying to run away from Fly. They do have the second life available on the Wraith King. He's away from his team. The roll comes down. That's going to land. The Ice Flash following through. They get that kill on a Moose. They'll take out the Earth Spirit. He fought back in the last fight, so he's dead for 70 seconds. The Torrent Storm is used. Emo is gone, though. MJT is the second one to fall on the side of Thunder Predator with the right clicks coming out from Minos. That's not going to be enough. They've got the Hex. They've got the Shekel. They'll have the control to take out the Wraith King. The Aether Remnant only locks up one. It's not enough to save your Wraith King has to come back. This is tough.
Of course, they're not going to give up. They're going to fight until the very end here. Elimination on the line. Troll.
Ice Blast.
No ages.
That's not going to be enough. They caught themselves the Void Spirit. They'll get the kill to Leo style. He does that buyback. He's going to buyback immediately with the Torrent Storm going off as well as the Supernova.
That's Megas.
They've got the racks. They've got the Megas. They've cleaned up here. Roll
who's
out.
Going in?
And that hits onto the Kunkka once again with the BKB being popped by JT. He's got DX, Leo style. You gotta remember, he just fought back, torn up into the air. They've got the shackle on a Moose. He's caught out, and look at the right clicks coming in. Moose not dead just yet, but the Ball Lightning will finish him off. Emo gets the kill with the Vortex, holding up Leo style. He's silenced, he's gone, dead for 90. Who knows, there's not much he can do without the rest of his team, and two of his heroes are already dead. The allies are gone, and his life might be going away with it.
Possible to get a pick off. They need to be very careful about EG's like Roche taking potential because of Tusk.
Is baiting here as he's got the BKB, he's ready to fight. They do commit on him, but already over to the side. Krynhard sees they'll collapse on nothing to say. They bring down the leaner, and now Arbed, Dream Coil, locked down onto Arme. EG will be able to turn and take down both cores as the Arteezy bait works perfectly. Yeah,
Arme.
He's looking at farm, but they're waiting. Arteezy's ready to go. He pops the BKB, the static link. They're just setting a trap every single time.
Oh, three Dream man Coil
is under the three of them. See if they can do more with this EG as they're chasing over. Lightstriker raid down onto Crit, Supernova from the high ground, forcing PSG LGD to run. The shards won't grab anyone, but Arbed, he's still trying to chase on for this. He's up into the high ground. See if they can get any sort of stun landed as he comes out of the face. If
they
can't
he's
out of there, Arbed. It's Crit. He's got his eyes on nothing to say. They're in with the jump initiation, punch into the snowball, nothing to say. We'll pop the BKB, but he's already fallen too low. He'll come down off the back of this Yules to an instant death there. Over to the side, Arme. We'll get the Blue Coast Command out. Ice. Drops the Nether Toxin and the Viper Strike onto Arme. As Arteezy is in with the BKB and the Static Link. Arme's gone. They'll lose to the Lion. Three dead yet again on PSG LGD. Fate Beyond's trying to chase down Fly, but Fly's got backup. Crit jumps in over towards the DP. Fate Beyond will be able to turn, take the two of them down, but he'll lose his life for it. Four dead on PSG LGD, and Arbed's not done. He's up to the high ground, chasing down Y, critting as well as they'll force back the ET. Arteezy's in with the slow. It's a team wipe as EG clean up every single one of them. PSG, LGD, all dead. Razor, the final pick and the build that he's gone for, that really has just sealed the deal on top of everything else. Mid lane, diving in onto nothing to say again, having to put the BKB and running. They do turn, get the Hex, the Light Track Array onto Arbed, but the Eon Disc is good to go. Arbed will be able to jump out to the side. Arme trying to get in on this, but here's Arteezy. Swings around, BKB and Static Link down onto the Monkey King. Arme has got nothing that he can do here as Arme's down yet again. Arbed diving down the rest of them, jumping around over towards Xin Q and Y. Crits him with the punches onto the Elder Titan. Y goes down. Xin Q whipping himself out of the game as Arteezy, he'll help with his whip as well.
Back, Y. Backed up by Arme.
the attempt to start something onto Fly. Xingqiu, yeah, he's going to come in with a Rolling Thunder.
Oh,
big crit. Comes out from Arme onto Fly. They've actually caught Artesia here inside the pit. Jump in from Arme. They're going to be able to find Artesia. It's a double kill for Arme. They're not done yet.
Yeah,
jump
they will
up,
go
a
back
triple
inside.
Kill. Yeah, Artesia's just going to look to get his farm back on. Get that PKB done before the next fight. Ooh, we are going to have Crit in a bit of a spot of bother here as Arme and Faith behind a fountain. The backup comes in, but Crit's gone. Artesia with a two-man concoction, though. Jumps over, gets both of them.
Oh, nice
both
dodge.
Faith behind and Arme. Arme's down the once. Why? Heading up with the cooldown. See if Arme's able to get any more kills out of this. Turns over towards Artesia. Jumps in with the dagger. The phantom strike. Artesia silence. Arme gets a second. Two kills here for the PA and PSG LGD. They're not done. They're looking over towards Arme.
He's out of spells. Has the Yule Scepter for himself. Maybe to buy a bit more time.
Arme with the damage. Arbet, he's up in the air. One more crit would do it. Arme looking for the kill. He's going to be able to fight. Oh, Fly. He's got to run. But Ice coming in. Xingqiu. Oh. The Ravage come out, but the BKB immediately there from Arme. Arme jumps over towards Artesia. Artesia commits with the BKB, but the rules out from Faith Beyond. Looking
where are the crits
Artesia
at? There
the
they are.
From Arme takes down Artesia. Over towards Crit he goes. The BKB from Arme now coming to an end. Arme controlling him with the Remnant. Arme getting low, and he turns. Another crit. Another crit.
He's just
Arme
cleaning
triple
up.
Triple kill. There's flying Arbet, the last two left alive, they've got to run. Arme's going to look to get back in the dagger. Flying over towards Arbet. Arbet over to the tree line with the Dissimilate. The SGLG, they're going to continue to chase. Arbet, what's he got left? Dagger in, horse to the side, missiles on his way over. Arbet, he's going to get stunned.
Give him the rampage.
Yeah, give him the godlike. They're flying. Where's the smoke up from EG? EG, they're going to walk into a player. It's going to give the chance for the BKB to come off here from Arme. Artesi tries to stay on target. Hasn't got enough damage from the rapier, but with the satanic, Arme, he's back up to full HP. Jumps over towards Ice. The Ravage comes out. The BKB comes to an end. Artesi's in, and he's taken Arme down. Ice perfectly holding the Ravage, ready for the BKB to end, gets the kill. We'll see Arme getting caught in the combo on the high ground. Roar out onto Artesi.
Artesi
needs help. They're in on top of it. Crit comes in with a snowball save. Buyback
from
the turn of Arme. And Ice, they're on their way back over Artesi. He needs help, and he needs it now, but he goes down. Arme will be able to recover the rapier. Can he get it back to safety? As he's up in the air, Astral Step ready, and still a Dissimilate. Arme's
got
to run.
It. He's got to save.
Here we go. Roshan to be taken very, very quickly here by PSG LGD. Is there going to be any chance to get in? There's not. Crit tries, but Roshan's already gone. Arme just turns towards Crit. 1600 damage as Crit's gone out of the game. Arme over towards Artesia. The roar, the crits are there. Artesia's down as they'll manage to kill him off. Death for 80, and it's over with the rapier gone. GG is called.
Little bit of a window, though, with no exorcism for a minute.
That's mid lane.
They got the
Arme's
jump.
He's going to show. They jump in. If they got the chain locked down, they get the vortex off. They pull him in. Arme's getting low. He's able to put the BKB. Turn towards the egg. Arme's able to take the egg off. Jump to the side. He's still alive. Zip forward from Arme, though. He's looking to finish him off.
Miss.
The evasion. The evasion. Arme's still up. He's still away. Over to the side. He goes to side.
Miss.
Stopping the axes from coming up from Ice. But
he gets him.
He's diving in. Another jump. Arme still lives. The blood rites laid down in the axes from Ice. Finally cut Arme down. There's Arme dead for a minute.
It's a risky one, you know.
Top crit. He's got the setup here as he's able to find Fabian on his way back towards
Roll
the base,
up.
But Fabian's got backup. Arme having to pop the cheese as the crits come in from Arme, but Arme, he's been ruptured. Rolling Thunder will hold back Artesia for now, but they're diving in. The Supernova's out. Arme having to pop the BKB, get up to the high ground. Will turn, still having to stand the ground. It's the rupture still in Artesia. Chasing on, looking towards him.
Arme.
The Supernova said he's going to be able to catch him as Arme steps back in range of it. Arme dead for over a minute, and EG, they're not done. They're going over towards Nothing to Say, chasing down the Death Prophet. The Fear will push back the two of them. As well, separating him from Nothing to Say, but Artesia is ready to zip back in with the movement
Big
speed. Nothing to Say goes down. Y also falls, three dead on PSG LG. He's gonna press it. Oh, here we go, Arme. Oh, what's he doing? He's out and he's in. He's over to the side. PKB's up, but the Supernova's down.
Another
he's got a rupture. Run, but he's been ruptured.
He has no HP, Arme. No satanic.
He's bleeding down low. He's gonna stand his ground, but the Arme comes in with a zip on the back. He's found him with the vortex. Arme getting low. Can he turn? He's still holding Arme. That's Arme dead for 2 minutes, but Artesia
so
he's full in return. Oh, Arme. That's Arme dead for 2 minutes, but Artesia
so he's
full in return. The buyback's coming out, but there's no buyback available from Artesia. Zip forward. Arme with a three-man vortex drags them in. Buyback is available.
Oh,
wide, but Arme brings Nothing to Say low. BKB's out, but Nothing to Say will fall. Arme in off the high ground over to Fabian. Triple kill for Arme. Roar from Ice. They're moving on to Y. He fought back for this. He'll get taken down. Faith behind the last one left standing as Crit rolls in with the stun over towards the Pango. It's game over.
Arm, he'll be at the top, but the rest of the team really doesn't get much out of the map at all. Where IG right now, they're splitting it up pretty well. They land the Shackle. They're going to follow it up with the stun as well as the finger. They've got the Hex on Tanisha. He's in trouble. Snowball save.
And is it going to be enough to keep this Kunkka alive? It's not looking likely. They'll get the kill on Anisha, though, covering Yapzur, and Tusk is not long for this world. Is it?
Oh, man. It works. I'm making myself laugh.
They've got the X as well as the boat coming in. They're going to try and get a kill here on Emo. He's all by himself for the moment, just trying to maybe use that Aegis and get this team of Secret as closed in on him as possible to turn this around with the help of reinforcements. They've done just that to get a kill on Azai. Yeah, they've used that Aegis, but there wasn't much time left on it anyway. And they're going to relocate right in, right into a Torrent. They don't get anything out of this just yet. Tusk as well as Nisha are going to back off.
Puppy.
Puppy. Earth Spike. That landed.
And they're moving into the Roche Pit? Really? It's so risky.
This is a risky play that I think they feel that they need. Power Shot already spots it, so the question is, do they want to stick with this? They're relocating.
Are you relocating?
Shards aren't going to block this. So he's tethered over onto the Earth, so they're going to look over at Matumba Man. They're going to go forward with this one. Kaka throws the sun out onto the Crystal Maiden. They've done a lot of damage onto Alu. Silence up. You've used that Essence Ring. Snowball onto the high ground, chasing over after Kaka. They've got the stun to get the kill. They'll take out one. The freezing field on the other side of the fight is Firefly. Focuses his attention onto Yapzur. He uses that Walrus Punch to put him up in the air, but it's not going to be enough to save himself. So a one for one so far. Zai right into the hands of
also no buyback
back in the previous engagement. So now 75 seconds without this Venomancer. They'll look over at Puppy, who will root up this Ursa for a moment, but it's not looking likely that Puppy survives.
It feels like as though Secret, all they can do is just watch them take the tower. Io occasionally coming in.
I think
in.
They might be waiting for the Aegis timing.
Yeah, which is now.
And right now, they're going to make the jump on the timing, but they don't go after the Io, they go after the Ursa. They've got the silence.
BKB popped the Alex.
Boat, Torrent, that's coming through on Emo, who popped the BKB. Ollie coming in with the borrow time being popped. He's up into the air with the Warlord's Punch being used by Yapzur, and they've used that ult, but Zai just taking so much damage. He ends up dead dominating here for Flyfly. They'll go after Nisha as well as Yapzur. They're going to try and cut off this Kunkka in the pass. Good shards to block him out for a sec, but the man is through, and Nisha's in trouble. Freezing field, right into the Io, but he's nowhere near dead. He's going to eat that cheese. He'll stay alive. Puppy gone, and Nisha soon to follow. They're right on top of these heroes in a split up fight. The Alchemist has to TP back to the base. Puppy, he buys back, and well, this is an Ursa in pretty far. They still get the kill on the Yapzur. They look over at Puppy, who just bought back. He's hexed up by Kaka. They're still looking over at Nisha, who got back to the base. The damage on the JT. They get the kill to the Windrunner, and they'll take him out. It's just one dead on IG, though.
Now, IG's looking to close on this game.
Looking for the Venno. Ooh, they're looking for the Venno, but they might even find more. They've got the Invisible Blade. They get the kill on Azai. He's going to be dead for 50 seconds. The damage is just so much. They're dealing with an illusion. Kaka blinks forward. He's got the Hex. They're going to look over as the finger hits out of Matumba Man. He's trying to run away with the BKB. Can he get up the stairs? Can he get away? It's not looking likely, as going all the way in is JT, who's gotten too far. Stunned up. Matumba Man still surviving. The Torrent will land. They get the kill on the Windrunner. They're in a little bit too deep there on the Windrunner, who ends up dead for 83 seconds with buyback. But the Ursa, who's been disarmed, disarmed again. He can't right click and he can't do any damage, so they'll get the Alk away. IG stepping forward pretty far.
Look at the health region.
The X. They'll pull back Flyfly, but it's not going to be enough. They've got the Abyssal Blade. And look at the damage coming in from Emo. He's attacking the tether target. And they've got that going to Yasuo. They'll get themselves the Tusk. Down goes Anisha. And it's just so much damage so quickly. He'll stun himself in the base. Are they going to dive? They were thinking about it. They turned in for a second, but they're going to get hit by the X as well as the Torrent. They'll look at turning this around as the ocean gets caught by Zai, but it's not going to be enough. They'll get the kill on a Matumba Man. They'll take him out and he'll buy back. Nisha now looking to chase as Emo and Flyfly try to leave the base. They've charged up the stun. They'll stun up Emo and he might just lose the Aegis, but this is only the first life that's taken out of the IO's hands. X coming out from Kaka. That's right on top of Matumba Man, who just bought back.
Oh, buyback on his
out. He might drop. He's down real low into the base, and the right click's coming through. And Nisha, he's bashed up, killed off, and gone. Kaka, as well as the Windrunner of JT, they're just not buying back because they're not needed at the moment. Emo, though, he's got the tether, he'll eat the cheese, he's back up to healthy, and now looking over at Zai with the right clicks coming in, he's godlike. Emo not getting stopped in this game, and IG are looking like they're on their way to taking game one. But here comes the snowball coming out from Yapzur with the Walrus Punch. It's still just not enough damage. You
Wait,
can't
the
kill
damage?
This ball of energy. They've thrown the stun over at a Flyfly, but they have nothing to follow it up, so they can just stand here ready to trade. They've got Abyssal Blade ready in just a second, so let's see who they go after. It's looking like they want Yapzur, who's going over to the top side of the base, but the Balls. Spirit's coming through. The snowball will be over at Emo. You've basically signed, sealed, and delivered your death.
The damage on the Alchemist!
On Emo. Haven't broken the smoke just yet, but they need to catch up to these heroes.
They'll need some sort of astral step jump to probably initiate here. They'll use the Yules onto the Abaddon, which I think already Secret are okay with. They'll use the Spear to lock him up. The borrow time gets popped. Yapzor coming over with the Hex. And now he's got this Phantom Lancer in a bad spot. They'll go to the Doppelganger. The arena's down with a Supernova. Can they turn this around on the side of IG? They're starting to retreat a little bit. That Supernova hits. They've got the Sunray right on top of the Abaddon. Yapzor ends up dead. They've got the Shadow Shaman gone first. They'll use the Primal Roar to take out JT, and they'll lose Ollie. Tears down on the side of IG as they land the two-man Earth Spike on a Matumbo Man as well as Zai. And they'll start their retreat even further, but it's not looking like Kaka's going to get away. The Primal Spring is there, the damage comes out, and Matumbo Man has a kill onto Kaka. This is money in the bank for IG if they can grab it. Matumbo Man coming over for a second with a Shikuchi. Doppelganger used by Fly just sent up in case Secret move in. Got a Sentry down, and look at the damage on the Flyfly. They've got the Yules up in the air. Is this Weaver? They've got the Aether Remnant, but the Valence Strike comes through and hits some of the bars as well as the Poison Spear. They'll use the Finger again. They get the gun up. Oh, man! Yes, they can. They take it out of the Weaver, but they look over now at Emo, who gets away with Astral Snap. Shackle is out on the Ollie. Ollie trying to get away, but he's got the Supernova available, and he'll use it. So the turnaround comes out from IG. They're going to look over the Abaddon. He's got the Ifada Shield on him. Puppy will try to TP out. The Air Spike lands on the Beastmaster. Astral Snap hits on the Monkey King as well as the Beastmaster. They should be able to get the kill on his side, and they will finish off. They look over now at Nisha, who's locked up and killed off. That's only the first life, though, as they'll focus their attention onto Yapzor, who doesn't have any mana to really save him. So they've got the Aether Remnant. They have blocked down the... Really well done to get into the pit. Seen it all. And ooh, thinking about going into the Wukong's command, he feints it twice. Let's strike. That's only going to land on the JT. The looks for attention onto the Mars, who throws down the arena. The look over is the Supernova was over to the side. The Finger's going to be thrown out onto the Monkey King. Nisha trying to fight the JT with a BKB. Supernova never gets off. They get the kill on Ollie. They'll take a JT 2 years down the side of IG on the backline. So it's the Phantom Lancer who's trying to get the Shadow Shaman. He'll get low. Flyfly gets the kill on the Yapzor, and now he'll look over at the rest of the team. But can he do enough? Emo's here to help him. The Aether Remnant only locks up a four, and they'll get the kill onto Nisha. They'll take the first life out of the Monkey King. They got the side of three for the axe picked up by Emo. They'll use that time lapse. Matumbo Man, after he's confident enough to fight, they hit the battle strike on the Emo, but continue to take those five. The Doppelganger, the illusion going after side. It's Secret got the Aether Remnant. They'll eat the cheese. Still surviving. Wukong's used, and out of the circle they'll go. But are they going to continue to chase on the side of Secret? They got the heels on a Matumbo Man. And again, the Doppelganger looking at the faces of Secret. They have the right damage coming through to Nisha. He survived so many times, but he won't survive this time. It looks like he's still fighting Flyfly. They've got three heroes going after the Phantom Lancer. Doppelganger once again.
It's all focused
on the Phantom Lancer. They've given up going after Emo, but Kaka comes back to fight. They land the Earth. What can I do? And they've got Emo back in the fray. Aether Remnant lands. They get the kill on Nisha. They look over to Flyfly, who's still low on health. Matumbo Man, he's been hexed up by Kaka. They'll get the kill to Weaver, and they look over at Beastmaster as well as Puppy. Got the borrow time pop, trying to TP out. They can kill on the Zon. They look over at Puppy, who's being taken out of the TP. Tier 3 is going to drop here, and IG is looking to make a statement. They're going to jump in with the Astral Shaman. They've got the Silence out of the Abaddon as well as the Shadow Shaman. They get the kill on the Abaddon. He's going to be forced to buy back immediately with the borrow time be popped by Puppy. Oh boy, Matumbo Man, he's on buyback 52 seconds without this Weaver, and it's looking like the hopes are starting to go away. They've got the heels up into the air onto the Monkey King, who threw down the Wukong Span. They've got the Aether Remnant, so even though he's got the circle out, he's being controlled, and he is in some trouble. Aether shot thrown by the Abaddon. It's not going to be enough to really deter the side of IG. They've got the Silence coming in from Emo once again. Look over, Yapzor jump back, speed chase by Flyfly. Battle Strike comes in, and that's going to be the Void Spirit. They should be able to get the kill. Shadow Shaman, they do. Emo goes into the disassemble, trying to die.
GG!